So today I'll be talking about synthetic monitoring, what it is, why do you need it, and how do you want to do it? You know, like the basics to, you know, how to get it implemented at your organization. So who am I? I'm Suraj. I'm working on Grafana Cloud these days for past 1 year-ish. I've been busy building synthetic monitoring product for Grafana Cloud. Before that, I was at early stage startup, and built bunch of core things from, like databases to ETL pipelines and whatnot, including monitoring also. So that's who I am. Also, so let's just define, what is synthetic monitoring. So we all have monitoring on our systems, right? We monitor what our servers are doing, what our databases are doing, how much CPU we have, how much CPU is being used, how any other, resources that we have on our services, and we alert on that. But we, like most organizations, don't really know how applications are doing from their users' point of view. Are users in certain locations seeing a degraded performance, right? Your internal monitoring will say everything is fine, things are running as expected. You would not know these things unless you monitor things from your users' point of view. So that synthetic monitoring, you test externally visible behavior as your users would see it. And if you have users all over the globe, you would need to monitor all over the globe. Like, also, synthetic monitoring is part of this, broader black box monitoring category. So sometimes we will also refer to it as black box monitoring. But like in this talk, we'll just call it synthetic monitoring. So quick question. I just wanted to ask everyone, how many folks here have used synthetic monitoring or are familiar with synthetic monitoring? So feel free to, unmute yourself and let me know if you use synthetic monitoring, and if yes, which product do you use? I heard Cisco uses Black Box Exporter in last talk.
We mostly use, it used to be Runsco. We are migrating towards New Relic.
I see. Nice. Any other folks who are here who use synthetic monitoring already? Okay. So I guess it's not as common as, other monitoring practices, right? So why do we need synthetic monitoring, right? As we said, we want to find out how our application is doing from our user's point of view. So to truly find out how our application is doing from user's point of view, we actually need to pretend as if we are users, and then test our applications as if our users are using it, right? And if our users are all over the globe, we would use it from all over the globe. I want to share a personal story of mine. I made a change that broke production for 4+ hours, and we didn't even notice that production was broken for 4+ hours. And the change that I made was I added a route in load balancer to redirect traffic to our new website. So, a fairly small change. Nobody thought it would impact production, but I don't know how. I still don't understand. I think it was something on like Google's load balancer UI that I did. But because of that change, actual production traffic was also ended up going to website. We didn't notice it until late that evening. It was 11 p.m. and we had a scheduled maintenance. We started doing scheduled maintenance, and then we found out that we cannot really use our production application. It was down and it was returning errors. And things were all fine from inside. Servers are up, databases were up, all good. So what actually happened was, our actual production traffic was being routed to Netlify because that's where we had our website. And I looked through header and I saw an ex Netlify header. And that's when I found out that, we messed up, right? And then we fixed it. Assuming we didn't have that maintenance window, things would have gone for longer and customers would have been impacted. But yeah, that's how I took down production for 4 hours and didn't knew it that production is down. We also had instances where our monitoring went down, and in those scenarios, during an outage, monitoring went down and we didn't had anyone alerting, right? Nobody told us that our own customers told us instead of our monitoring systems. So that's not a good state to be in. And also, assuming you have regional deployments, right? You have configuration that apply to certain configuration apply to certain regions. Let's say you do a deployment and your team is sitting in one region, developing and deploying globally, and things are only broken in that region. It would be really hard to know that, because from your point of view, from your region, things are all fine. You can use your application, but customers in that region would either see your application broken or in degraded performance. There was one such incident that happened with folks at k6.io. So Daniel is SRE at k6.io, K6 recently joined Grafana Labs. So I was talking to him about K6 and synthetic monitoring. And here is what he said. So they misconfigured Cloud Frontend. Because of that, they had a regional caching issue. Nothing major, things were slow in one region, and they wouldn't have found it because there was no way to find it. Because folks in other regions were seeing it all fine. But because of synthetic monitoring, they saw the response times and latencies were up in that region, and then they hunt down and fixed it. So, it's not just me who breaks things. It's almost all of us. So, yeah. So another question that I want to answer is how to do synthetic monitoring, right? We talked about we want to monitor from our user's point of view. We want to monitor from user's point of view. So that means we have to leave our internal private network, get out of it, and monitor from actual internet. And we want to travel through the internet, just like our users would, going through different networks and then reaching our production services. So even if you, let's say, use Google and you set up your infrastructure on Google and you use Google to set up another monitoring, then you would still be, going through Google network unless you tell Google to not go through Google network. So it's a bit tricky to actually go through internet if you are not going out of that cloud provider. Because Google has its own optimized routes and whatnot. They do their own networking magic to make things fast and try not to leave their own network. So that's also another important thing when you want to do synthetic monitoring, right? Because you want to make sure that you're actually coming through regular internet where your users are coming through. So another is exactly how to do it. So there are two options. One is you can do it yourself. Black Box Exporter is popular project in Prometheus ecosystem. So if you have Prometheus, you would want to configure and deploy Black Box Exporter at locations where you want to monitor your application from. And also you have to be extra careful about the networking magic that other big cloud providers does. So you have to actually leave your cloud provider and deploy it on other cloud provider that you don't use, right? There is one more project from Google. I think it's called Cloud Prober. I have never used it, but it's supposed to be used for, you know, black box monitoring, synthetic monitoring. And then there is always cron jobs. So you can write cron jobs to ping your websites and, you know, monitor them, but that's not really scalable and easy to manage. Also, there is a trade-off, you know. There are certain pros of doing it yourself, and then there are some downsides of doing it yourself, right? Like when you do things yourself, you have full control over what data to collect, you know, where to store it, how to format it, and whatnot, right? Like you can do whatever you want. You don't have to start from scratch. There are existing open source tools, right? Black box exporter is there, but I'm pretty sure there are others as well that can do based on, you know, how you want to monitor, what you want to monitor and whatnot. But the downside that is that now you need to monitor this service, right? Now you need to maintain this service. And let's say you have, you know, certain assets like, you know, marketing websites and whatnot, then people who are not, you know, engineering savvy would have to go through the engineering to get their services monitored and, you know, have their checks up and running and, you know, modify those checks as well. So that could be seen as a pro and could be seen as a downside, because now you have one more hop and, you know, engineering have to be involved. So, yeah. And again, the meta monitoring question comes in, right? You use synthetic monitoring to monitor, you know, your overall application, but who monitors your synthetic monitoring, right? As Joy said, it's turtles all the way down, right? So another solution that you have is you use a managed service. It's easy to use, no engineering overhead. Most managed services have a nice UI where people can just, you know, put in a URL or an endpoint and they would start monitoring it. You know, they have global locations. You can select where you want to monitor your applications from, and then they'll take care of the rest, right? You don't have to worry about operating it and then monitoring it and then again meta monitoring it. There is also another downside of that. You know, they might not have locations that you want, right? Some have, you know, let's say you want to monitor your application from a location where they don't offer their probe, right? And there is no way to gather data from that location, right? Also, most you know, managed services don't mix well with your existing white box monitoring, right? So you have all of your internal data, but then, you know, let's say you use an managed service. So that service will have its own UI, its own way to look at data. So people will have to learn how to use that service, you know, learn how to get data out of that service. And then, like, it's not easy to mix with your existing data. Let's say you're using Grafana, and then there is, like, you can set up things to get your data along with your other data, but it's work. So also, let's say you have some internal applications that you want to monitor. You know, they are inside your network. You don't want to monitor them out from outside your monitor, but you just want to make sure that they are up, you know, things like VPNs and whatnot, and, you know, things that are critical for your organization, you know, because almost every organization have internal applications that are not public per se. So the only way to reach those applications would be to be in your network, and not every managed service offers that. So that's managed services for you. So now I'll, instead of, you know, going over all the managed services and all the open source solution, I would just talk about, you know, what we have at Grafana Cloud, because that's what I've been building for past a year or so, you know. So Grafana Cloud Synthetic Monitoring, you know, looks something like this. It's inside your Grafana instance lives as a plugin. You know, you can monitor things from all over the world. But you know, people who know Grafana might say, wait, wasn't it called, you know, WorldPing? Didn't you guys had one more service that did exactly the same? Then you would be correct. You know, there was a service, you know, was because it's already EOL'd last April. And right now it's on read-only mode and will be taken offline on August 1st. So WorldPing was the very first service from Grafana Labs. That time Grafana Labs was called Train Tank. It was also a synthetic monitoring product, but it had, you know, a bunch of things that we wanted to improve upon. And ecosystem has decided to move on to, you know, Prometheus. And this WorldPing product was using Graphite as its data format. So it also had locations. It would also, you know, run your checks all over the world. And then it would gather metrics and then store it in Graphite format. You know, there was a bunch of downsides with that. You know, Prometheus is easy to extend. You can throw in labels and, you know, like do what a bunch of things with it. Also, PromQL is very powerful. So Graphite was like, we were feeling like, you know, we could make it better, but because of Graphite, we couldn't. So we decided to deprecate WorldPing and then move forward with the world and, you know, like move to Prometheus-based world. Also, another, you know, major requested feature was, let's say you have a check running from, you know, a remote location. And only that location is failing. There were no logs as part of WorldPing service. You know, like your checks would generate logs, but then we would, like, there was no feature to show those logs to you, right? So customer would have to either, you know, create a VM or, you know, like use a VPN to browse services from that location and then debug that. And that was, you know, suboptimal and painful. You know, like, we don't want to do that. So logs was another, you know, major missing feature of WorldPing. So like, this is what it was. So 2015 WorldPing came out, 2016 like it came inside, 2016 it came inside Grafana, was app plugin. And then like today we moved on from WorldPing and shut down WorldPing and have developed synthetic monitoring that is same product but different, new and better in various ways. If you want to know more about, you know, what is different from WorldPing and you know, what's new in synthetic monitoring, my colleague Teddy wrote a blog post about that. I have, you know, links to this slide. You can go to this blog post and then read more about the exact product differences that are there. So, you know, why new products? You know, the world is moving to Prometheus. You know, almost everybody is adopting Prometheus. All major vendors support Prometheus ingestion, Prometheus querying. So we also wanted to, you know, move with the world and have Prometheus-based metrics for your synthetic monitoring data. Also, the logs that I mentioned, right? We want logs. We don't want our you know, customers to have to connect through a VPN and then try to reproduce a problem that our probe is seeing, right? You know, sometimes they couldn't reproduce because, you know, in internet, right? You know, like, it's not like the only way to know why certain things happened is, you know, collect logs and then tell you, okay, like, this is why it happened. New synthetic monitoring products product have logs, and also, like, because it is built on top of Black Box Exporter, we have all the configuration flexibility that you get with Black Box Exporter, right? We expose all the configuration options. Also, Black Box Exporter exports Prometheus metrics, so because of that, our synthetic monitoring product also has Prometheus metrics, and we integrate well with our Grafana cloud offerings. So, you know, like metrics are stored as Prometheus metrics in your Grafana cloud hosted metrics instance, and logs are stored in your hosted Loki instance. So if you want to mix and match with your other data that you have in the hosted metrics and hosted logs instance, that would work out of box without any pain. You know, like you don't have to feed in data, collect data, get it, get the data around, and you know, worry about it. It's already there. Also, it is inside Grafana. You don't have to use another tool. You don't have to teach people to use another tool. It's all Grafana and Prometheus, and it integrates well with cloud alerting. So Grafana has cloud alerting product. It's a hosted alert manager offering. So if you can actually use the same alerting infrastructure that you have, right? Infrastructure to manage your alerts, manage your routes, manage your rotations. You could just use the same thing for your synthetic monitoring. You know, you don't have to go to another product, you know, add people to it, and then configure email alerts, you know. And because it is Alert Manager, you get all the great things that Alert Manager has to offer, you know, including places where you want to get alerted from, you know, like be it PagerDuty, email, Slack, Telegram, whatnot. So, yeah. Another bit that we have in new product is Private Probe, right? So Private Probes are probes that you can run in locations where we don't have our probes, or inside your internal networks if you want to probe your internal applications. So Private Probes, like you give it a token, bring it up, and then it would connect to our API, get all the work that it needs to do, and do start doing its works, and collect metrics and logs from the checks that it executes, and then pushes them right back to our cloud. So you just need to run a process. That's it. And if you want to run a Docker container, we also have that. And I'm assuming almost every organization can now throw in a Docker container somewhere, right? And if not, you know, we also have other ways to install it. So I want to, you know, do a live demo right now, you know, so all hail demo gods. But yeah, there we go. So I have synthetic monitoring installed in my personal Grafana cloud instance. You can see it, like that's the icon. Let's go to the home. So I created a bunch of checks for this demo. So this is last 3 hours. So I have, it supports DNS, HTTP, TCP, and ping checks. I don't have any ping checks, so that's why it's only showing three of them. And then it has all the regions where we want to look through. So there is an instance for my DNS check. So I'm doing a DNS check on my website, and it says reachability 99.8%, and latency up and whatnot. And these are my, you know, HTTP check, and this is my TCP check. So let's look at the UI. You know, like let's go through and create a check. So this is the UI where you see your created checks. You know, you want to see a compact view. You can see how many location it's running from. You know, what's the frequency? How many active series it will generate? We don't bill on your check executions. We bill on the data that you generate and store. So there is no separate billing for synthetic monitoring. You don't have to worry about, you know, how often I'm checking. If you generate more data, you'll get billed more. And if you generate less data, you'll be billed less. And it's all part of, you know, your Grafana cloud hosted metrics and logs billing. So you don't have to worry about, you know, paying one more service and then, you know, what other billing woes that you have to see. Also, there is this new, you know, visualization view if you want to look at your checks at a glance. So, you know, so I see like these two checks are failing. This is successful. This is successful. Okay. So let's go ahead and create a check. So these are four check types that I can create. I have to define a job name. So whatever you write will be sent as a job label in your Prometheus metrics. So let's monitor Google, because why not? So I can just say google.com, and I can just say service, you know, these are, you know, your query parameters if you want to send to your service. Let's see, you know, like where I want to monitor from. So all these are, you know, hosted probes, and this is my private probe. I'll go over to private probes later and show you how to set one yourself. So I'm running this on my laptop right now, and it's executing checks and sending data right now. So I'll select all of them. I want to run it every 60 second timeout after 3 seconds. So there is this button. So what this button does is, by default, we don't publish all the Prometheus black box exporter metrics, because you know, we believe that, you know, not all metrics are useful. So we only, you know, like they are useful, but you know, if you run tons of checks and if you are not using those extended metrics, then you would end up paying more. And so like, if you want to only look at basic metrics, you can just leave this unchecked. But if you care about all the metrics that black box exporter has to offer, you can check this and then you'll get all the metrics. So this is just, you know, if you don't care about all the metrics and don't want to pay a high bill, you can select HTTP method request, body headers, you know, normal stuff, TLS config, you know, you can give us a certificate. And then if you have a bearer token, basic authorization thing, so you can put your bearer token inside here, or you know, have your username, password, if your service is behind authentication, you can do validation, HTTP versions also, and see, like, check for SSL. Also do a regular expiration match on your headers and body. Like, all this is already there in black box exporter. This UI makes it easy to configure and you know, intuitive, so people don't have to write black box exporter configuration. You can add labels to your checks, so they will show up in your metrics and logs. So let's say you have a team label, team Google, and then you know, you can use them however you want. You know, also we have IP version selection. You know, let's say you only want to monitor through IPv6, or you know, let's say you don't really care about this. And we have built-in alerts that are you can use this and then configure default alerts based on, you know, your uptime and reachability. So, and those alerts will be there in Grafana Cloud Alerting. So let's go ahead and save this check. Okay, showing NA because it's not running yet. It will take a while to go and, you know, start generating data. So these are all the probes that we have been running for you. Like, you can go click see, okay, this is public. That means that, you know, this probe is hosted by us, and you can run your checks there. There is also a private probe that I'm running. So this is my private probe that I'm running on my laptop. It says online, you know, I'll go ahead and kill it, and then it'll show up offline. So it is offline, you know, let's bring it online again. So we have synthetic monitoring agent on our GitHub. So whatever code that I'm running as private probe is actually open. So you can go and look at the code if you want. So the code is at GitHub, Grafana synthetic monitoring agent. So that's what I'm running. Like, I'm not running some random code that, you know, you don't want to run in on your network. So should show up online. afterwards. Okay, so it is online. The success rate here is, you know, the amount of checks that succeeded on this probe. And then there is this alert. So like, if you know how to configure Prometheus Alert Manager, and if you want to configure your own alerts, then like you can leave this alone. But let's say you don't want to mess around with the synthetic monitoring metrics that we generated. You just want basic checks on, you know, let's say if my service falls below 95% or 90% or whatnot for 5 minutes, then you can just say save alert, and then this would generate an alert manager rule in your Grafana cloud alerting service. Same for other services. And if you remember, in check creation there was a alert sensitivity feature. So like, we add low, medium, and high label in your checks. If you configure that, and then you can target those checks here. You know, so these are three default alerts that we add for you. So let me go ahead and show those alerts. So I'll go to the cloud alerting product. And if you see, this is alerting UI that is for Grafana cloud alerting. It's, think of it as a hosted alert manager, because you know, it is alert manager. You know, this is alert manager configuration. You have silences, you have notifications, and you have your rules. So there is one rule that I created. You know, website is slow. So if my website takes less than 5 seconds, I'll alert for greater than 5 seconds for 5 minutes. And I'll say my website is slow. This is what I have created. And these are the default alerting rules that are part of synthetic monitoring. And then like, we create this recording rule for you. So you don't have to type the same query again and again. So, yeah. I'll go ahead and... So we import 5 dashboards, 5 default dashboards as part of synthetic monitoring. So like, we already looked at summary dashboard, right? But there is a dedicated dashboard for each check type. So there is a dashboard for DNS, ping, HTTP, and they are your normal dashboards. So you can go here and see them, you know, along with all of your dashboards. Put them in a folder. So let's look at the DNS dashboard. Let's see what's happening with my DNS queries, right? So if I look at DNS, it says Bangalore 3.57%. So it says uptime 100%, reachability 99.83%. So uptime means that only like at least one probe is able to reach your service and confirm that your service is up. And reachability means, you know, the overall combined ability to reach, you know, all these probes. So let's say if one probe is not able to reach, or, you know, if it's getting error, then your reachability will start decreasing. That means that you're not really reachable in certain location, latency records, like whatnot. And this is the logs. So you see that there are some errors coming from, you know, Bangalore probe. And you can see what happened. So it says error while sending a DNS query, IO timeout, like really helpful when you want to debug something. So it says beginning check timeout. So it says check failed duration 5 seconds. Okay, check failed duration 5 seconds. So that means if I go ahead and look at the check, times DNS. Okay, so this is our check, right? I configured five second timer, right? So like, if it takes more than 5 seconds, I'll consider this check has failed, and I'll run this every 5 seconds. Go ahead and, you know, increase and decrease this based on my threshold, but yeah. Let's look at the HTTP dashboard that we have for our HTTP services. So I'm monitoring bunch of websites. So let's look at the Google check that we added just now. So this is our Google check. We see it's up, but it's not really reachable. Could be because of our threshold, but you can debug, right? Why it's failing. You have all the logs from your checks, and these are your normal low-key logs. You can go ahead, explore on them, run all the logQL that you want. Let's say I want to do show me only errors. I'm not a logQL expert, so I'll write bad logQL, but whatever. So it's cannot assign requested headers. Okay. I can go ahead and do show context. That TCP cannot assign making HTTP request, resolved target, whatever. So there is some issue, like you have the logs to debug it, right? Whatever. And let's say you have, it shows SSL expiry, right? So you can alert on SSL also. So I'm assuming almost every service offers that, but just wanted to show that you also have this. In the response latency, you get a breakdown by how much time. So if you look at this, majority of time is going in resolve. And then the check actually fails. So that's why the other metrics are zero. But let's look at my website and see what's going on. So you can see that my home network is not as quick as other probes. So it's slow from my point of view, but it's fast. When we look at other Atlanta and Bangalore probe, this is what I mean when I say network is not uniform. So you have to actually monitor from all over the world and go through actual internet. Synthetic monitoring, like you can just look at your checks like this, whatnot. And these are the probes. You can see what version you have and whatnot. But anyway, I guess that's all with the demo. I wanted to tease it out and say what's next as part of synthetic monitoring. So we are in process of planning and building traceroute feature in it, to trace how Atlanta probe is reaching to your service. You should be able to run trace routes from our probes. Once we have this live, you will be able to run trace route and look at the data and visualize it and see how it travels all over the internet, right? It's particularly useful for folks who want to do network monitoring and whatnot. And smoke ping. So the current ping feature that we have, it only sends one ping packet, but that's not really good when you want to monitor your response latency. So smoke ping would send a burst of pings, and then you can look at the data and see how it's doing compared to a single packet. Though no promises on when these things will be out, but hopefully they'll be out soon. Okay, so now let's say you say, like looks neat, how do I get it? I want to use it to monitor my home lab. I want to use it to monitor my personal project. So Grafana Cloud has a free tier without any credit card or anything. You can just go sign up and use all the Grafana Cloud features, including synthetic monitoring. So you have metrics, logs, traces, alerting, and it's more than enough to monitor side projects, home labs, and personal projects. And even if you want to play around with alerting tools, like alerting, observability tools, and learn things, you can go ahead and use our free tier, learn things, play around with Grafana and Prometheus ecosystem. The graphite is also there, but you know, I'm assuming nobody wants to learn graphite these days. So that's all from my side. Thank you, everyone. You know, these slides will be available, I'm assuming, on the Hasgeek platform as well. And if you want, you can go to my website and download these slides as well. I'm there on the internet. You can reach out to me on Twitter. You know, write an email. My email address is there on my website. But yeah, so I'll stop sharing and we'll go ahead with the questions.
Of course, the last slide kind of got to me. I was, anytime this feature is coming to the open source integration, like, see, the probe is open source already. So is there a way to set up my personal open source probes across multiple other clouds? Let's say I'm hosted on AWS. I can put a probe in either, you know, Heroku, DigitalOcean, GCP, wherever. But Grafana, I'll still need to register with Grafana Cloud. I don't have this feature on my self-hosted Grafana. So is that anywhere in the product pipeline?
So, you know, in last couple of months, we were busy with, you know, deprecating working and migrating those users off. So we were only focused on you know, the cloud as a data storage, because that's what we needed from, you know, organization product point of view. Yeah. So that's what we have. As of now, that's not there on the roadmap because we have a free tier. So, you know, if people say, oh, I want to play around with it, then we just say, you know, free tier is more than enough, right? We have 15K, you know, active series that are allowed. Also alert rules and logs are there. And synthetic monitoring, if you look at the checks, we tell how many active series it will generate, right? So some, like, you can monitor hundreds of endpoints of synthetic monitoring with free tier. Let's say you have, like, there is one part, you know, that you can do. Let's say you have your local Grafana and you want to install synthetic monitoring. You can configure cloud as a storage destination, install synthetic monitoring plugin on your local Grafana, and provision those cloud data sources in your local Grafana, and synthetic monitoring will work on your local Grafana.
Loop through the cloud once.
Yeah. So it will collect data, sent to cloud, but you can use it.
Get back to our local centers.
Yeah. So
still seems a roundabout way, but I'm pretty sure with Grafana stack track record in near future, we'll be able to see this integrated with the open source version, but fingers crossed from my side at least. Other than that, like, if I want to do this at my org right now, we do have a very distributed customer set, then I'll have to go the black box exporter route, I think, and set up custom probes through that, right?
Yeah. Like, as of now, if you want to store data on your own and store logs on your own, then I think black box exporter is the way. But I would say, like, even if you have your own internal Cortex and other services, you can still use free tier just for this, and install it in your local Grafana, provision those cloud data sources, then, you know, mix it and match it with your in-house data, and then this data.
I don't have any other questions. The whole thing looks pretty simple enough. I have used, I think, Blackbox Exporter once way back in only one of the orgs I've worked in. But that also is for just a simple full system ping test, not a distributed test across everything. We just were monitoring our external infra from one location, not like all locations possible. But let's wait for any other anyone else from the audience to pitch in with questions, because this is definitely a super interesting topic personally for me. So anyone else has questions on this?
Hey Suraj, this is Ashok here. So very interesting. We have used Black Box Exporter extensively. Use it all the way from SSH check to ping and everything else. Mm-hmm. That's our easiest way of finding, okay, something is up. on the availability front.
Mm-hmm.
So one question I had was, see, when we do it, at least currently when we do it the cloud way, what are your thoughts on the latencies? Because I have to go back to cloud and then come back, then measure something, right?
No. So cloud is where you store your data, right? So the checks are executed all over the world.
No, I agree. What I'm trying to say is, since I'm storing, the latest data might not actually be the latest.
Oh, okay.
I might not get the real-time data.
Oh, okay. So I think the latency should be fine. You know, we have, I think, two regions as of now in Grafana Cloud. I'm not sure if you can choose your region in the free tier, but...
I think it will get better over time, as Joy said.
So I would say give it a go, install on your Grafana, like play around with it and see how's the latency. Shouldn't be a problem, you know, from what I think.
Yeah, in our space, like enterprise, pushing anything to cloud is forbidden. So yeah, we'll try on our own.
Oh, I see.
Yeah. And it's also not about just enterprise. I think most orgs, even if they are not enterprise, posting their own Grafana and it's a pretty standard pipeline, right? Like Grafana Cloud only becomes, it's only at a certain scale, it becomes, you know, important, right? Or like at a very early scale or a very late scale where, you know, managing a self-hosted cluster is sort of getting too much over it. At that point, you can rely on a cloud. But in the mid-tier or in super scale or like, you know, like as Ashok said, in the enterprise scenarios, people have their own Grafana setups already. So there has to be a sort of a good way to integrate this pipeline with the Grafana dashboard that people already has. As you correctly said, Suraj, that, you know, we don't want to see the data in 2-3 different dashboards, right? The same would happen if we have our own self-hosted Grafana dashboard and Grafana cloud dashboard just for the synthetic side of the thing. So some integration would definitely be super awesome and nice, but yeah, let's see how that works.
So if folks are fine with keeping this synthetics data in cloud, then, you know, you can install the app on your local and configure it, you know, give it data sources, give it credentials to connect to cloud. So then you don't have to go to two Grafana instances to see this data. Like it will all be in single instance, but again, the data
you have
is
to pay with cloud. Some latency, of course, like if you're doing a three hop thing, then you have to pay with some latency. But I think, like, from a historical point of view, that would still be relevant enough. Maybe not a P0, P1 point of view, but we can still analyze historical data of from certain locations. If too many customer complaints are happening from a certain region, right? We can figure that part at least out.
Yeah.
Anyone else here does this with any other tool sets in their org? We can start having that banter session and discussion, I guess. We still have online time till at least, let me just check the time right now, according to the schedule, 12:50. So 2 minutes till the live stream ends. So you can still have us ask questions, or we can take all the questions to the scheduled banter session that we always do, where we go off the record and we can talk about everything under the sun. Till the time, like, are there people here who are already using other sort of toolkits to do synthetic monitoring?
Telegraph has a HTTP and a TCP plugin, I guess, with which you can do synthetic monitoring. We have tried it a couple of times.
So I think a lot of the self-hosted setups would basically be deploying your pin test monitor infra across multiple locations, and then get the data to stream to your central monitoring location or the meta monitoring location, something like that, right?
Yeah.
I'd like to add something. Okay. Yeah. So, so I've started consulting a while, just a month back. So the company I consult right now, they're using Pingdom for basically ping tests and all of that. And recently, they kind of faced an issue where the tests are basically just timing out, not even able to reach and all of that. So we're just exploring what new options are available apart from Pingdom. And I think Datadog has been offering of synthetic monitoring because they've been using that. So what are you guys, what do you guys think about like Datadog synthetic monitoring, and do you have any views on that? Because like we have not been using Grafana Cloud, so it would be difficult to suggest using a completely different product for it since they've been using it. So it seems like a good option, more or less. And also another question of mine was, like if a product is region-based, like for example, just in India, like how, like you won't have so many probes to check. Like mostly data centers are either in Mumbai or somewhere else. It's just like one or two probes that you would get in a specific country or something like that. So if you wanted to do more of a regional check, like if customers from Delhi can connect or customers from Chennai can connect, how would you do solve that kind of problem? With like something like Datadog, or maybe you have to do something in-house.
You're still limited by where data centers are hosted and
exactly.
Unfortunately, for our tier two and tier three cities and those customers, there are no data centers out of which you can run your black box tests, right?
Yeah.
So not really sure. You can leverage a couple of mid-tier sort of bare metal companies which have certain other data centers, but other than that, not really. Anyone else would pitch in on this?
So I would say using bare metal offerings and then running private probes on them would be a way to go. And if you really want to check from user's point of view, I would say send a Nuke to every employee of your company and then let
them. If you do have a
data, right.
Run, ask them to
send
run
a Raspberry Pi and
that seems like a good option.
I'm going to the extreme, but
give your customers discount to run a probe from their end.
Oh yeah, just built it into the app itself.
This is what I think a lot of telecom companies do, right? If they're putting up a tower on top of your building or something, you get a flat discount or some payment out of that. So this is already sort of a business practice in certain domains. So leverage that. Not sure.
Yeah, I was in Gojek before, so we used to use Datadog for all of that, and it didn't used to, because we didn't have a website and stuff, so didn't used to have that many of problems. So yeah, this is relatively new.
But Datadog also won't do like Indian region based splits, right? It will still do maybe Delhi, Chennai, Mumbai, Bangalore. There's no data center in Bangalore, so you're limited to Delhi and Mumbai and
Mumbai, yeah.
Maybe Chennai. There is a couple of places. Hyderabad has a couple of DCs, I think, but not sure. You're limited by where Datadog has a center, right?
Right.
And they don't have much fine grain, if I believe. They only have India grain. They don't have state grain, right?
Right. Okay.
Also, like I was looking at Cloudflare workers, but they don't allow GoLang, so I can't run. Otherwise, I would have deployed it on Cloudflare workers and suggested that as a solution. But yeah.
Yeah, that's a good option as well.
Maybe you can write something of your own in a language that they support and then deploy.
Yeah, just write a shell script.
Yeah.
I'm going back to old Zabbix and those days. All probes were shell scripts. There was no fancy language. You used to use grep and sed and opt to filter out the data point and send it.
Right.
Nagios, anyone? Zabbix.
At every point of time, every new software was a shell script or an Excel sheet.